Oh, I need to fill up petrol. I hate filling up. Just so time consuming, and I hate having, I just don't like it. Anyway, so we're gonna fill up tomorrow. Hey, what is happening everyone? My name is Rhea, and man, I'm a master procrastinator. But I just crossed the threshold of regret. The part where I hope that I've done so much more. Well, we still have time anyway, it's only midday. So today I'm going to show you how I took inspiration from a $3,000 wall art decor from Restoration Hardware and taking this wooden pallet. It's no longer there, but the memories are still fresh. Let me show you what it was doing. It's been on the floor. Maybe I should do this because it was taking so much space, but it was on the floor, on the garage floor, for almost 2 years now, acting like an absolute rat, being a complete waste of space, and it was doing my head in every time I came into the garage. So we're gonna take that and create something beautiful from it. Let's go. Okay, so the original piece is called Reclaimed Belgian Block Cutting Board. And the story was that the granite bricks that now pave several European cities, they all came from massive slabs and they had to be laid on these wooden boards when they were being cut. And as they were being cut, these massive saw blades were creating these grooves on the board. And what they've done was take those boards and repurpose them and finished it with a thin layer of concrete. So I used a circular saw to create the grooves on the surface. I initially tried to do this without a guide, which is that white piece of wood that you see there, but I barely had any control of the saw. So it's definitely a good idea to do a trial cut first. Unless you have good control with the saw, then definitely go without a guide. Also, don't forget to adjust the depth of your blade as well. Then I just cut at random widths apart to make it appear regular. I did the same process vertically, again at random widths apart. This time, I didn't cut it all the way through, so I just did a broken line pattern. I then cut off all the usable pieces. Then cleaned up the edges by cutting it straight. And then while I was doing this, I thought, if I just simply laid all these planks next to each other, it'd be too obvious that it came from a pallet. So I cut the planks further into smaller pieces and again at random lengths, and you'll see a bit later why I think this was a genius plan. Then I stained every single one of them. Again, I used the color Walnut by Cabot's. I applied it on the surface with a piece of cloth, and this just darkens the surface and makes the grooves pop out a bit more. For the backing, I use a 3mm thick plywood cut to size again with my circular saw. This process has been so enlightening, watching myself work on projects and gain more insight about how much I actually procrastinate. You don't see it here, but I actually dry fitted these wood pieces more than 4 times with no real purpose after the first time. Just, you know, moving them around a centimeter closer, 2 centimeters away from each other. Anyway, so I just eventually got sick of doing that and started gluing. I began gluing from the corners and the sides to make sure that they're flushed against the edge of the plywood. I also laid some of the planks ever so slightly slanted to create uneven gaps in between them as well. It's now the next day, but the night before I tried applying cement in between the pieces where the gaps were, waited overnight to see how it held up, and also to see if the color actually matched the wood. I thought the contrast between the warm wood tone and the cool tone from the cement was a bit jarring. So I made another cement mixture and I mixed in some yellow and warm brown acrylic to warm it up a little bit. Then I placed it in a Ziploc bag cut the tip off and use that as an applicator. When applying the cement, I'm particularly interested in the areas that I wanted more focus on. For instance, see that cut that's just smack bang in the middle? It feels like it just screams, you know, oh, it's a wooden pallet, because it looks so uniform. This is where the extra cuts I made earlier came in handy. Applying the cement in between those cuts sort of draws attention away from the middle. Afterwards, I just cleaned it up a little bit with a pallet knife. And finally, I finished it with some cement over the surface. And then we start framing. I made a video on how I created these frames from brand new wood to make it appear weathered and rustic. Definitely watch that for a step-by-step guide on how to achieve this look. So I cut the frames to size, then glue the frames together using a butt joint because that gives it a more vintage look as opposed to a miter joint. Then I just glued the frame to the art piece itself. And I am so proud of this piece. It's probably one of the best ones I've made. I can't wait to show you. Let's roll the reveal. Until next time.